Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. Here's my list of 10 accessories that you should seriously think about getting for your Mac. MacMost is brought to you thanks to a great group of supporters. Go to MacMost.com/Patreon. There you could read more about it, join us, and get exclusive content. So let's start off by looking at the only accessory that I think is not optional. You should always have a backup. So get an external drive and start a Time Machine backup if you don't already have one. They can be pretty cheap. They can start as low as $65, and for about $100 you can get a 4 terabyte drive. The key is make sure you get a USB 3 drive. You don't want any old USB 2 drive. They're much slower. And there's really no reason to get one that has that external power. You should be able to take this thing and plug it right into your Mac and that's it. No extra cables. When you search for portable drives, that's pretty much what you get. Next, if you have a Mac that doesn't have a battery, so in other words, not a MacBook, so you have an iMac, a Mac Mini, or a Mac Pro, you should definitely be running an uninterruptible power supply, or UPS. These devices can be relatively cheap, and even the cheapest ones will give you a couple minutes if the power goes out for you to save your files and shut down your Mac gracefully. Now, one problem Mac users have when buying these is that they often come with software, and the software is for Windows only. That's because you don't need that software on a Mac. In System Preferences under Energy Saver, you'll have all the controls you need if you want to connect your UPS to your Mac to get extra readings like the amount of power in the battery. Or you could not connect it at all. I don't. I just use it as a regular UPS and know that if I get a power outage, I just want to shut down as soon as possible and not try to work for any amount of time off of the battery. You could spend a lot of money to get one that has all sorts of extra features and can keep you working for a half hour or even an hour after power goes out. But at the very least, just get a cheap one so you don't instantly lose all your work the second you have a power outage. Now, if you use a digital camera, chances are it has an SD card in it. There's no reason to carry around that cable and connect your camera to your Mac directly. As a matter of fact, usually transferring files that way can be pretty slow. Instead, pull the SD card out of the camera and use a really cheap SD card reader hooked into your Mac to transfer the photos. Make sure you get the right type. If you have a MacBook, you're going to want a USB-C connector. If you have an older desktop Mac that only has USB-A, make sure you get one with that. Another cheap little USB device you can get is an HDMI adapter. These allow you to connect your Mac to any screen that's using HDMI. Now, just about every classroom and business meeting room has a projector with HDMI nowadays, so there are plenty of opportunities to use this. Plus, when you're on vacation, you can plug your Mac into the hotel or Airbnb's television this way to watch Netflix. Just make sure you bring along a cheap HDMI cable to go from this adapter to the TV. Now, hub is something that a lot of Mac users can't live without. If you need to connect a lot of accessories, you're going to need something like this. It serves the purpose of adding more ports to your Mac. It also allows you to connect one cable to your back and then have a whole bunch of accessories hooked up to the hub. There's a lot of variety here, for ones that just have USB ports, the ones that have SD card readers, HDMI, power, all sorts of other things. And make sure you get the right one for your Mac, either USB-C or USB-A. Now, if I was using a MacBook Pro as my primary Mac, I would no doubt have a second power adapter. Having only one adapter means it has to come with you everywhere. Having two means you could have one at home or one at work or one in the bedroom and one in the living room. For a second one, sometimes you can even find them that have USB out as well, so you can charge your iPhone and other accessories from the same power adapter as you charge your Mac. But in general, this is the one accessory where I would recommend buying from Apple, because there are a lot of bad power adapters out there that just don't last or don't charge nearly as fast as the official Apple ones. Now, if you use a MacBook Pro, it may look indestructible. I mean, the thing is made out of aluminum, and sitting on your desk or on your lap, you may think, I don't really need a case for this. But when you shove it into a backpack or carry on, or you decide to carry it on campus with you, it could easily get scratches and dings, and it's worth getting a cheap case or a sleeve just to protect it. It's hard to find one of these that cost any more than $30, and you can think of them as disposable. One can take a little bit of damage and then you toss it and replace it with another cheap case. Now, I already recommended getting an external drive for Time Machine backups. Well, I'm going to also recommend getting another one for archiving purposes. An archive is when you have a file or project that is taking up a lot of space on your drive, but you're not really using it anymore. It's an old project. You may never even need it again, but you don't want to delete it forever. So you have a drive like this. You transfer files there. Now you still have them, but you're saving all that space on your internal drive. I've had an archive drive, as long as I can remember on all of my Macs. For less than $100 you get a ton more space to store stuff. Now along those same lines you can get a USB flash drive. Now these flash drives are small and very portable, but they're not nearly as fast as regular hard drives. So they're not great for actually working with every day. What they are great for is transferring files. You can format them as exFAT and then you could read them on Windows machines and on Macs. So they're handy to have in case you need to transfer files, especially large files between your Mac and somebody else's computer. And you can now get ones like this that have both USB-C for MacBooks and USB-A for all other computers. So the same data can be read no matter what type of USB connection you've got on your machine. Now here's the most expensive item on my list, but I think it's worth it. If you spend $2,000 on an iMac or a MacBook or something, why not get a second display? For about $300 you can get a 4K display that uses mini display port so you can hook it up with a cheap cable and you have an entire second screen on your Mac. Think about that. If you have a $2,000 MacBook with one screen, for $300 you could add an entire second screen to your Mac. The same thing for an iMac. That screen real estate can come in very valuable when you're multitasking. So this is definitely something to think about. And here's a bonus one. You may want to think about getting an external microphone. The microphones in Macs are good and they keep getting better with every generation. But there's still no substitute for an external microphone that you can get closer to your mouth. Now you could spend $200 and get something that's really decent like the ones I use. But you could also spend as little as $30 to get a decent USB microphone that will allow you to have much better audio. This is great whether you're creating videos or just using audio or FaceTime calls on your Mac. You may also want to think about getting a full headset to allow you to do calls with much more relative privacy, especially if you work in public spaces a lot. So you may notice I've left off a lot of traditional peripherals like printers and scanners. For printers I believe in trying to be as paperless as possible, and the same with scanners, trying to get as little paper in as possible. And if I need to scan something I find the iPhone works really well too. How about you? Which accessories can you not live without? I publish new tutorials every weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out. Then hit the little bell icon to get notifications for each new tutorial.